Hi, Raja.
Hello, Greg. Nice to connect with you here in this beautiful day of connection.
Good, thank you. I was doing forms back in the early 80s, but I started it as a business in 85.
Okay, well, and Moira and I were married in 84. And ever since then, I've been seeing it advertised in all sorts of various publications, and I was always intrigued about it. Metaforms, and the fact that it was has lasted this long is a testament to itself, but I never had a personal connection with it, but I kept seeing it. And I say one day I will, because pyramids are something that's very important to me, and of course, sacred geometry, as we've progressed through the years, learning what's behind all of the pyramid structures and formats. I've worked with quite a few other scientists and physicians who have come up with various types of energy devices and pyramids. But then my beautiful brother, Jonathan Goldman, connected us and told me, I have somebody dear I'm going to connect you with. And he sent it, and there on it was Metaforms. I said, oh, how wonderful. And so I was very happy to have this beautiful connection with you and to receive your beautiful little I.Connect, if I may go to that next level. Because once I received it in the mail and took it out, I went, oh, my heart melted. My soul leaped for joy. It was like a tiny little spaceship that I was able to hold in my hand. And that's what the guides all told me. After all these years, we've connected, and you're now holding in your hand a tiny little spaceship that's right up my alley. And it began sending me energies and everything. And as you know, my beloved Moira recently went back to Venus, left the Earth plane in December of last year, 2011. And immediately she said, oh, that's like my personal little ship now, Raja. I can now visit you very closely whenever you hold that and think of me. Of course, I'm in contact with her and the beautiful masters constantly in my life. But to have a little device that's full of energy and the masters love and the little space people can come in, I'm able to instantly change around anything, or I'm able to instantly infuse good energy into anything, or simply have the peace and comfort of something, like, you know, they used to call those little stones the worry stones or stress stones, where you rub them. You know, the ancient shamans just picked up a rock and rubbed them. But now we have something that's really dynamically energy charged, and I'm very happy.
So you've seen some of the research now that we're doing with the I.Connect, and what do you think about that?
Well, I thought it was absolutely amazing. Of course, I thought I already knew about it before I read about it, and then I realized, oh, there's a whole lot more involved than this. And so rather than just keeping it on my desk or using it somewhere like on an altar, the research said, no, the best thing to do is keep it on you all the time, because it begins to affect the energy field at all times. So I said, all right, I have a little bag that I put it in, and I wear around my neck.
So it's like what we've seen is it normalizes people's systems, I mean, all the internal organ systems, increases the energy field around the body, balances, you know, all the chakras, and brings things into center. So it's really bringing us into that place of connection where everything seems to center. And that's truly what it means to be in your center, is to be connected to soul and allow that energy to flow. And that's what this little tool does.
Well, that is truly amazing and wonderful for all our people here on planet Earth. May I ask you a question now?
Sure.
How did you ever come about designing and receiving all of the guidance for this beautiful piece and the work that you're doing with Metaforms?
Well, I've been working with sacred geometry for over 40 years. And in that time, I precipitated Kundalini shifts, started communicating with higher dimensions, talking to specifically beings that were directed by Archangel Metatron, and by energies beyond the Archangels that work through them. And so the way all of these different beings move energy into this dimension is working with sound, working with light, And on the physical third dimension, they specifically work with sacred geometry. Work with, you know, the way everything is created is through geometry. So when it came time to create the I.Connect, I had been working with sacred geometry for about 30, 40 years, and I had an understanding of many of the different aspects of how to shrink it down, to put it in a two-dimensional surface. And this specifically came about because my wife last summer was starting to tune in to the higher realms and saying, we really have to create this new tool. They're asking me, we have to get it done before Christmas. We have to have 21 of them or 24 out into the world spread around the United States. And so we put beta models together, and what we did is we spent a lot of time where we tested, we tuned in, we looked at different mineral connections and combinations. We work with different transition metals in here. We started working with fiber optic antenna systems, working with metal antenna systems, wrapped wires, certain lengths to pull in certain wavelengths of light. We've worked with some things I've developed with an electron beam. We vaporize certain elements, certain oxides, in a certain order and build them up on plates inside the I.Connect. And when we do that, it's like creating a miniature molecular structure that follows sacred geometric crystalline patterns that allows for more energy to come through. We were working with oscillating crystals, electronic components, circuit boards. All these are things we tuned in, we tested, we worked on. I worked with a lot of different people to bring this together. I had a friend who's an expert in sound, where we work with a large tube, this big around 4 feet high, that we wrap with wire and we put sound through it. And my wife was told the most important sounds and frequencies to bring through would be something that reflects the sacred name of creation, the sacred name of God, Source. And the best tool we found for doing that, the best sound tool, is Jonathan Goldman's Divine Name. So yeah. You've heard that, you know, that, yeah. And so that's where he's working with the chant that sounds like Yahweh. And yeah, it evokes so much energy. We put it through this tube, which at the same time, we have forms inside, geometric forms, one above the other. And these forms spin in opposite directions. What that's doing is it's creating vortexes of energy that then, with the sound, charge the I.Connects that are wrapped individually in purple silk. The whole unit is connected to a form that I have on my land that is at a vortex where we are creating a vortexual flow through the entire planet, because I have on the opposite side of the planet from us, almost perfectly, is Uluru, which is what the Americans called Ayers Rock, but the Aboriginal name in Australia is Uluru, and that is a very sacred vortex where we have buried a similar form as to what we have on our land, which is based on the phi ratio, the way the human body is created. So that's creating a toroidal flow, an energy like a donut moving through the earth, coming into my land. I wire that to this tube that has the sound going through it with the forms in it. And we've already activated these with ultraviolet light, for a certain amount of time, and then we put them in the chamber, which connects to the whole Earth, and it goes through the grid of the planet. So we're doing so much to create energy flow through this little piece that it is shifting people's lives in a very profound way. And the nice thing is, it's not my energy or my thoughts or my programming, but it's simply that this piece opens a doorway, opens a channel to allow higher energy to come through from other dimensions and move that through the individual. So once that's happening, then it's up to the individual how they work with that energy. It's just priming them to be able to do whatever it is they want to do in their life to create wholeness, to create connection, to be able to increase intuition, to be able to manifest things. And as you saw from what goes on with all the research that we've been doing, people are able to start creating a very balanced system with all their internal organs, with their chakra systems. Their energy field increases because they're connected. And this is what we're supposed to be doing on the planet. We're supposed to be connected to Source and bring through that love, bring through that energy of who we are. It's just that, you know, the toxins in the environment block us. The things going on with the EMFs, the electricity, it blocks that flow. All of our own emotions, whenever we're upset, when we're angry, when we're sad, we disconnect, and that flow of energy that's supporting us, that's keeping us vital, that's keeping us active and evolving, it shuts down. And when that shuts down, what takes over in the body is something called the flight or fight response. You know, this is something old from when we used to need to have the body react to the saber-toothed tiger so we could get out of there. But now, what's strange is that it's turned into something that when we're sad, we create the same response in our body. When we're angry, we create the same response. When we get inundated by the EMFs or the toxins, it shuts down that connection to Source, which is our lifeblood, which is what is keeping us growing and alive. So the body's response is the same thing, the flight or fight, and that shuts us down. It starts creating a situation where the adrenals start working to create cortisol, the liver starts pumping out things, and all of this creates inflammation in the body, which now we're finding that's one of the main causes for all disease. It's like heart disease is something that we find scientists, you know, doctors find cholesterol, you know, stuck to the arteries, so they say, oh, the cholesterol is the bad guy. But really, the cholesterol is just the bullet. You have to look at what's the gun that shot the bullet and who pulled that trigger, who's guilty. And that's what it comes down to. The gun is this flight or fight response that gets triggered. Literally, the trigger gets pulled when we get upset, when we go into judgment and we separate ourselves and we say, I don't like what you're wearing, or this makes me unhappy. In our heads, we're thinking that we separate from Source. The body goes into, oh my God, I'm going to die without connection. And it does the whole thing again around stupid little stuff. When our room's messed up, we judge it and we separate. Or we get angry at someone and we separate. Or we eat food that's not good for us and we separate. All of it is the same response for the body, which is killing us. And this tiny tool, the I.Connect, is making such a phenomenal difference because it creates connection. It allows energy to flow and people come alive with who they truly are. It's time for our higher selves to come in and run this personality, and that's what's beginning to happen, especially with the help of this tool. Because, and the nice thing is, it's a tool like a hammer that would help you build a house. But in the end, you're the one that built the house, not the hammer. And in the end, you're the one that decides how your life is going and what you're supposed to be doing in connection with your soul running the show. And the personality, the ego, gets to come along and have fun because it's being taken care of. It doesn't have to pretend that it's separate anymore. It doesn't have to pretend that it knows everything and it is the one running the show. Because truly, it's your heart and your connection to the divine part of your being that is here to bring through more love and serve everybody on this plane of existence.
Awesome.
That was it.
Yeah. So I'm wondering, Greg, if you can take a close-up of the emblem that's on the top of my hat here. You can see it's a Metatronic cube. There's miniature stars of David that go around there, five-pointed energy stars. And so it's very related to the metaforms. And you mentioned the Metatron and going the angelic energies beyond the Metatron energies.
Okay, Raja, this is one of three views of the three-dimensional star Metatron, which is an expanded version of Metatron's cube that you were just referring to that is on your hat. You see, to resonate with the energies of a three-dimensional form in a two-dimensional system like the face of the I.Connect, we need to capture the three perspectives or three axes of symmetry found in every three-dimensional form. So there are three different forms with nine different views on the I.Connect face. The view in the upper left, demonstrating the six-pointed stars, is a very close duplicate to what is on your hat.
I got this emblem on the hat. I was at a gathering where I was drumming. And I had the I.Connect in my pocket at that time. And this gentleman that made these came up and said he felt compelled that he needed to gift it to me. So I said, it's a beautiful emblem. Why not? Let's put it right on my hat. So that evening, I'm holding the I.Connect and I've got the emblem on and I'm drumming. And all of a sudden, I meditate. Usually I have my eyes wide open while I'm drumming. But at this time, I'm drumming and out from the clouds comes Enoch, all the beautiful angels. Everything was white, just pure white. The clouds were white. White doves were coming out of the skies. And there were sacred geometrical forms all in white. But I didn't want to open my eyes because whenever I did, it would go away. I closed my eyes and this vision was overpowering, taking over the whole landscape, and these beings and these energies were coming in to the drumming area and around all the people that were dancing while I was drumming. So I felt it was definitely the connection with the I.Connect brought this person who makes these metaform emblems. He gifted me with that, and the drumming, the shamanistic energy of the drumming all made this beautiful vision come. And it was as if that was the purpose of the drumming and the work, is to create that space where the sacred dove and the sacred archangels and the blessings from the higher planes come into the planet.
It was absolutely a connection, and that's the purpose of the I.Connect, to create connection. And it flows in the way for every being that's appropriate for them. So what a joy and what a wonder.
Yes, indeed. My whole body is tingling as I realize the blessing that we're receiving here from your beautiful offering to the world. And I just want people to know that I'm very happy to have this opportunity to offer this over the Stardoves Network, the Metaform products, the I.Connect, and everything that you do, and blessings.
Thank you, and blessings to you. Thank you.